We'll start off in Denver, Colorado, where Alex is on the line. Alex, you're on the Ken Coleman Show.
Hey, Ken, how are you doing today?
I am living the dream, sir. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good.
Good. How can I help?
So I just want to get your advice on something that I wanted to start up. So currently I'm starting to move a little bit closer toward my sweet spot. I'm currently in a job that I really enjoy, but at the moment it's not quite there as far as being able to help other people and to be able to do what I want to do. So currently I'm just in the IT field, working with technology and computers, mostly on a support side, but I want to be able to expand on that and possibly even break out and start into my own small side gig that would eventually become my full-time job. Mm-hmm. So I'm just wondering if you have any advice or any things about maybe where I could start on maybe looking into starting my own company or maybe starting my own service where I could go out and help people with their IT needs.
Yeah, I'll give you two basics that I would give everybody in this situation, and then I want to learn more, and let's get some very specific steps, but some basic overall steps that I want you to know is, number one, I want you to test. Test this idea before you launch it. Test it. Friends, family, acquaintances, people that are willing to try it out, or companies, whatever the situation is, the product or service, you got to test it. A lot of people don't test it. They launch, then test. You don't have to launch in order to test something. So test. You got the idea? Test. And then secondly, you want to start slow. Start small. Stay steady. Start slow, grow slow. That's the other piece of advice, because one thing that will kill a lot of entrepreneurial ventures is when you try to start too fast and move too fast. So start slow, grow slow. Now, what is the side business? What is it?
So it would be like an at-home IT service. So instead of you bring your computer to a shop to get it repaired, I could be able to come to you and fix your computer or fix your network at your home, and it'd be a lot easier for the client, and then where they wouldn't have to go outside their home to get help.
Okay. How do you compete with the fact that a lot of these people are maybe having internet connectivity issues, and whoever's providing their service is going to come do that for them? Are you talking about like actual hardware, software problems?
Yeah. So hardware, software, it would be anything network related. So anything in the home, IT related, I would be able to help them out with.
Okay, great. Well, so now this is a great example of the idea of just testing the service out. And the way you test that out is you do it for some folks and just charge them, you know, for your time to come out and do it, and just do it for a few folks. And you're getting some recommendations. They're going to, you know, be referrals for you. They're some of your early clients. You don't have to necessarily launch a business just to start helping some people do this. But then the idea of doing this on the side, you know, this is another easy thing here for you to just begin doing it on nights and weekends, and you determine how much time you actually can give to this, so you don't get overwhelmed, you know, between your other responsibilities and your family and hobbies and whatever else you do. So I would start this pretty darn soon, because it's on the side anyway. And how much money do you need to make to replace your current income?
Probably about $50,000.
Okay. So this is a really easy side business to start. So what's your question for me? When to start it? How to start it?
Yeah, so probably just some general guidelines on where to get resources to be able to look up good resources to be able to start an entrepreneurial venture. And, you know, if you've never done it before, how to get information that you don't even know about.
Yeah, great. Well, I'm going to give you a copy of my friend Christy Wright's book, Business Boutique. So Madison will get you a copy of that. Even though the title says helping women, you know, create a business doing what they love, it gives you all of the basics. So it's extremely practical for guys as well. It's not a gender thing. So that book will be very helpful in what to think about, from business licensing, you know, paying your taxes, you know, how do I get it going, S corp, C corp, all that kind of stuff, you know. So that will get you started there. But then you also need to talk to, beyond Christie's book, I would recommend you talk to somebody who has launched a side business or a small business in that field. Find somebody, a friend of a friend of a friend, and go sit down and talk with them as well. And they're going to give you some really practical stuff as well. So between the book, Business Boutique, which is, you know, kind of helping you get it started, and talking to somebody who's actually launched a small business in the IT field in your area, that's going to be all you need to know. There's nothing to be scared of. But early on, you don't have to do all that. You can just go get paid, you know, and have them pay you. You know, it's 1099 income, but just to get started while you're learning all that other stuff.